Hi friends, in previous class I have seen about keyword match types, keyword planner tool. We have also seen various Google ad extensions and all. In today's class we are going to see about what is an ad rank, what is quality score, what is actual CPC and how to create a display network campaign and all. Let's see about that. Okay, let's start with the ad rank first. Okay. So what is this ad rank, right? So it's nothing but position of our ad on SERP. Okay, so whether it is first position or second position, okay, it is defined as an ad rank, position of our ad on SERP. So if you go and see here, if you search in Google for something like digital marketing training or whatever it may be, okay, we might see some ads there based on the keyword we search for. Okay, so here this is the first ad, which means their position is, their ad rank position is 1. Here their ad rank position is 2. Their ad rank position is 3. This is known as ad rank. Your position of, okay, position of our ad on SERP is known as ad rank, right? So as we have seen before, in SERP structure, it max we can have 0 to 4 ads on the top of SERP, and the bottom of the page you may have 0 to 3 ads. Okay, so it max how many ads we might see on SERP? It max with 4 on top, it max I can see 4 ads on
down
top. 3 on top, right? On in total, so I can see 7 ads. Okay, it max I can see 7 ads on an SERP page. So our aim is to bring our ad the top position. Okay, I should display my ad in one of the top positions. Okay, based on it, it depends on various factors. Okay, let's see about those factors. Okay, so ad rank score. Okay, it depends mainly on ad rank score. So what is this ad rank score? There is a formula. Okay, it is max CPC. Okay, means max cost per click, or you can simply say it as bid amount, the amount we bid. Bid amount, it depends on bid amount, and it also depends upon the quality score. Okay, on these two factors our ad rank will depend. Okay, it mainly depends on ad rank score. Okay, so let's see what is this quality score first. Okay, then what is this quality score? Your max CPC means the bid amount we are going to bid. Okay, we'll be saying that per click I'll be paying this much amount to Google, right? That is known as max CPC or bid amount. Okay, so let's see about this quality score. What is this quality score? So it is nothing but a Google's rating given to a website. Okay, it ranges from 1 to 10. It is based on various factors. Okay, this quality score also depends on various factors, like, so it ranges from 1 to 10. It is a score given by Google to a particular website. Relevancy. So ad relevancy, and next thing is, it also depends upon CTR. CTR means click-through rate. And next factor is landing page experience. So the quality score depends upon these three factors, and it varies from 1 to 10, which is given by Google to every website. Okay. So now let's see what is this ad relevancy. Okay, so our ad content should match with the keywords. Okay, if someone searches for digital marketing training like such, ad should appear for digital marketing training only. The ad should not appear like SEO training, data science training like such. Okay, so though SEO training is a part of digital marketing training, okay, our ad is not totally exactly relevant to the user's search query or user's keyword. Okay, so here our ad content should match exactly with the keywords people are searching for, right? That is known as ad relevancy. So next thing is click through rate, CTR. Okay, means so let's think that some people are searching for our business, then our ad got displayed on SERP, then how many people are clicking on our ad and how many of them are navigating to our website. It is also important, click through rate. Okay, so means total number of users visited our site by clicking our ad versus how many times our ad has displayed on SERP. Okay, so if my ad got displayed for 100 times, means if my ad got 100 impressions, okay, then how many people clicked on my ad and visited my page? It may be some 20 people later. Okay, so this is known as click-through rate. This thing is also having a formula. Okay, CTR equals to total number of clicks by total number of impressions. Impressions means how many times our ad got displayed on SERP or whatever, maybe other platforms. Impressions means if our ad gets displayed once, it is known as one impression. Into 100. This is the formula. Okay, so total number of users visited our site by clicking on our ad versus how many times our ad has displayed on SERP. Okay, this is known as click-through rate. Okay, please say me one thing. Let's think that our ad got displayed for some 50 times, but no one clicked on our ad and they went to our website. Then what does it mean? No one interacted with my ad, which means my ad might be irrelevant to the keyword, or my ad's content is not good. Okay, there are many factors why people are not clicking on my ad. So please take care. Google will also consider these things. How many people are clicking on your ad? So it displayed for 100 times, but no one clicked on it for once also. Why? What is the reason? There might be some issue, right? So issue from our side itself, right? So Google will think all these factors. So please be careful. So this click-through rate is also known as interaction rate. Okay. So interaction rate means if people interact with our ads, then it is one interaction. So that's why it is also known as interaction rate. How many people are interacting with our ad? Interacting means clicking on our ad. So obviously when they click, they will navigate to our website. That's it. Next factor is a landing page experience. Okay, so after clicking on the ad, they will come to our website. Okay, but if we people are redirecting them to some irrelevant page, will they feel good? My ad got displayed on SERP. Okay, the visitor clicked on my ad. Okay, he came to my website. But then taking him to digital marketing page, I'm taking him to some other page like Python related training and all, is it good for him?
No, ma'am.
No.
It will not be good. So always keep a proper landing page, redirect people to proper landing pages only. So after reaching the page, if you see any irrelevant content, the next 2 seconds itself, he will close our website and he will come back to SERP. Right? So Google even considers how much time people are spending on our page. Okay, so how many seconds he spent on our page? How many pages has he viewed after visiting our page? Okay, like that, Google will check each and every factor. Okay, if all these things are good, if ad relevancy is good, if click-through rate is good, landing page experience is good, we'll be getting a good quality score. Okay, it may be from 1 to 10. Okay, if you get a quality score like 8 or 9, it is very good. Okay, so next, let's go for this actual CPC. So we have heard about CPC. CPC means cost per click. Per click, how much we'll be paying for Google. So now what is this actual CPC? Okay, so we have seen two things. Okay, first factor is max CPC and second factor is quality score. Okay, so let's see what is this actual CPC also. So other than max CPC, there is another factor called actual CPC. Okay, in case of max CPC, we'll be saying Google that it max I can spend 100 rupees. Within that 100 rupees, you can bid whatever amount you want, but my ad should be on top. Like that, I'll be saying Google in case of a max CPC in order to get maximum. But in case of actual CPC, okay, so if we say Google that I'm ready to bid 10 rupees per click, will Google take away the entire amount? Will Google charge the entire 10 rupees?
No, ma'am.
No, Google will not charge entire 10 rupees. Okay, it has some formula based on that thing, it will charge. Okay, so ad rank score of below competitor. By your quality score plus 0.01. This is the form. Okay. Okay. If we say Google that I'll bid 10 rupees for each click, then Google will not take away the entire amount. Okay, it will charge us based on this formula. Okay, so ad rank score of below competitor by our quality score is 0.01. So first let's calculate this ad rank score. Okay, so that we'll get an idea how Google will give ranking. So ad rank is nothing but position of our ad. So how Google will give us a particular position like that, let's calculate once. So ad rank score equal to maximum CPC, that is bid amount into quality score, right? So let me take three factors like A, B and C. So now let's think that the bid amount is 2 rupees. Here for B, I'll take the bid amount as 4 rupees. And for C, I'll take the bid amount as 6 rupees. Okay, next quality score. I'll guess some quality score. Okay, so no one will know how much quality score their website is getting under. Okay, and also we don't know how much our competitor is bidding. It's just for our clarity purpose. That's it. Okay, we are taking a guess that Google may charge like this if they are bidding this much of amount and if they are having this much of quality score. Like that, we are taking a wild guess because we don't know how much our competitors are bidding and what is their quality scores and all. Let's think that their quality score is 10. A's quality score is, and B's quality score is 4, and C's quality score is some 2 like such. Okay, so now what is the ad rank score? Okay, I have to say me. Ad rank score is equal to, this is the formula, max CPC, that is bid amount into quality score. Means what is the ad rank score for A? It is 20 because 2 into 10, 20. Then what is the B's ad rank score?
16.
Yes, it is 16. Okay. It's okay. No worries. And C's?
18.
12, right? 6 to the 12. Okay.
12,
right. Okay, this is the ad rank score. Now, what is the ad rank for A, B and C now? What is the position? What will be their position? Obviously, A score is 20. Okay. That's why their ad rank will be 1. Am I correct? So, A got a higher score.
Yes,
now,
ma'am.
B got the second highest score. Now, B's score will be some 2 like such. And the C score will be 3. Okay, based on the ad rank score, your ad's position will be defined by Google, right? So if you see here, okay, so B is bidding only 2 rupees. Sorry, A is bidding only 2 rupees. But as its quality score is 10, okay, with the lowest bid amount, it is getting displayed on top one position. So if you see here, C is bidding 6 rupees higher than other competitors, but as its quality score is only 2, okay, its ad rank score is like this and its ad rank position is like this. So if C wants to come on top, it has to increase its bid amount. Am I correct? So if it keep 10 rupees, okay, then only it will get a score of 20. So if you want to exceed A, then it has to keep 11 rupees, right? Per click, it has to keep 11 rupees. So the thing is here, not only the bid amount, the quality score is also very, very important. If your quality score is good, then with low amount also, with less amount also, you can display your ad on top. Otherwise, you will lose money. Okay, you have to keep on increasing your bid amount when compared to your competitors. That's why maintain a good quality score. Okay, so yesterday we have seen two things while seeing keyword planner tool, like low range bid and high range bid. So few people remember that. So in case of low range bid, by keeping some 12 rupees also he came on top. Okay, so in case of high range bid, he kept some 50 rupees some other time in order to come on top. Some other person kept 50 rupees for the same keyword in order to display his ad on the top of SERP. Okay, here the thing is, he came on top with the 12 rupees because his quality score is good. And here, his quality score is not good. That's why he has to keep 50 rupees in order to show his ad on top. This is where the thing differs. Okay, so not only your bidding amount, but also your quality score matters. So don't neglect your quality score. Okay, if your quality score is good with less bidding amount also, you can display your ads on top. That's it. Okay, this is about ad rank score. Okay, if you get a good ad rank score, your ad rank position, okay, your ad rank, which means position of your ad will also be good. That's it. Now let's see about actual CPC. Here in case of actual CPC, you'll learn how exactly Google will charge us. Okay, so now let's calculate the actual CPC. I'll simply name it as ACPC. Okay, so here according to the formula, so if you see here, ad rank score of below competitor, okay, ad rank score of our below, if A is the first thing, so what is the below competitor's ad rank score? His below competitor's ad rank score is 16 here, okay? So it is 16 by 10. Next, our quality score. What is A's quality score? It is 10. Okay, 10 plus 0.0. So equal to what is 16 by 10? It's 0.6, right? 16 by 10, that's it, 1.6. It is 1.6. Then plus 0.01. What will be the thing now? 1.61. Okay. So how much Google will charge? He is bidding 2 rupees of amount, but actually Google will charge 1.61 rupees only for A. This is the amount how Google will charge. So based on your competitor's thing and all, Google will charge you. It will not take away the entire amount of bidding, right? So let's go for B. Okay, so what is the ad rank score of below competitor in case of B? Yes, his C's ad rank score. C is the below competitor of B. So C's ad rank score is 12. Okay. Next, our quality score means B's quality score. It's 4. What is 12 by 4? It's 3. Plus 0.01. So now 3.01, right? So now Google will charge 3.01 rupees, even B is bidding 4 rupees, right? Now, what is the case for C? If C has any competitors, again, if C has any below competitors, it is okay. Google will calculate based on them. So if she do not have any below competitors, it is his bad luck. Okay, she will take his bidding amount as this original amount. Google will charge entire 6 rupees as his bidding amount. Okay, right. That's why your quality score is also important, and Google will charge like this. Google will work out like this. But the thing here is, we are just getting some clarity, but we don't know how much others are bidding, as it is a closed bidding in case of Google Ads, and we even don't know what their quality scores are. Okay, but here just we are, in order to say something like Google will not charge the entire amount, we are going through all this process. But in reality, we don't know anything about our competitors' bidding, quality score, whatever it may be. Clear till now? These formulae and all are a bit important. If you go for interviews, please make a note of them or remember them. Till now, we have seen how exactly Google charges and how Google calculates our position on a CRP, ad rank, right? So now let's move to display network campaign. We'll see how to display ads on various websites and all. So in case of display network, what will be the ad format, type of the ad?
Image, video.
Yes, it will be image, video, or they may be banner ads. Here in case video means, okay, they might be rich media interactive ads, RMI ads. Okay, image, rich media interactive ads or banner ads. Okay, where they will be displayed? These ads will be displayed on others' websites, some other websites, or they might be displayed on mobile apps or YouTube. Okay, like that. They'll be displayed on various places. Okay, so and what is the bidding strategy here? How Google will charge us? CPM. It's CPM. Okay, means cost per mile or cost per 1,000 impressions. Okay, Google will charge these people, okay, only if their ad gets displayed for 1,000 times. Okay, so if this thing, if their ad gets 1,000 impressions, impression means if their ad gets loaded to the visitor once, it is known as one impression. Okay, if it gets displayed once, like so, it is known as one impression. So like that, this ad should get displayed for 1,000 times, then only Google will charge a certain amount. So let's go to our Google Ads and create this display network campaign. Okay, so go now. Simply create new campaign, or else you can go to campaigns and click on play symbol. So what is the difference between display network campaign and search network campaign?
It will appear in CRP page and these will appear.
Right. In case of search network campaign, our ads will get displayed on CRP. But in case of display network campaign, our ads will not get displayed on CRP. They will be displayed on some other websites, YouTube or mobile apps. Okay, and also in case of search advertising, okay, our ad will display only when people are searching for it, right? People will search for our particular business, then only our ad will get displayed. But here, will they get displayed only if people search for them?
No, ma'am.
Wherever, I never seen about this tranquil till now, but I'm getting this ad. Why? Because here, these ads will not get displayed to people who are searching for. Okay, they'll get displayed to random people also. Okay, there are also some techniques. So they might be creating some brand awareness like that. Okay, if they want to create brand awareness by showing their business to each and everyone like such. Okay, it is the one of the best ways to choose display network campaign. It is mainly helpful to create some brand awareness. Okay, so right. Next, yes. So I'll again choose create a campaign without a goals guidance because I have an idea to, which campaign should I choose like that? I have an idea. That's why I'll be going for that. Now, which campaign type should I choose?
Display.
Right. So see here itself, it will say create visually appealing ads that serve across Google Display Network, YouTube, or mobile in or an app. Okay, learn different kinds of ads across the web. display. Okay, so here also there are the three types of campaigns. I'll say about Gmail campaign later. Here we'll be running ads on Gmail. So if it is smart display campaign, again we'll be doing nothing. Google will take the control. Okay, simply we'll give money to Google and Google will run the ads. Okay, bid amount and all, nothing will be in our hands. So always go for standard display campaign. Okay, so give your business name. It's asking for your business website. Okay, so I'll give one. Itchyready.in. Right, done. So click on continue. Right, so name your campaign similar to search advertising, but the ads will be displayed on some other platforms. That's it. So I'll name it as display 11 to 1 batch. Okay, it's for your reference. So next we have seen how to choose a location and all. Okay, I'll choose another location. I'll choose some Hyderabad or whatever it may be. Based on your business, please choose it. You can also include or exclude whatever it may be. So right, click on save. So here on the right hand side you might be seeing, okay, how many impressions your ad may get. Okay, like that you'll be seeing once you go for targeting and all. Location options here, you have seen these things also, to which people you want to show your ad. Okay, I want to show my ad to people who are residing in Hyderabad and also to people who are searching for it and all. Okay, so and in case of display advertising, it is your wish, because we are showing our ad to random people, right? So please keep that thing in mind. Language is English, it is good. Okay, and bidding. Now which bidding strategy you have to choose? We have to focus on impressions now, right? So I'll go for viewable impressions. Okay, so viewable CPM is your bidding strategy. Okay, so viewable CPM, right? So budget, how much amount you want to spend per day. I want to spend some 1,000 rupees, like such. Okay, so actually in case of this search advertising, you might be having some competitors, right? So you have to bid a high, you must have good quality score in order to display your ad on SERP, like such. But in case of display advertising, there are numerous websites, there are numerous YouTube channels, millions of millions mobile apps and all. So even you bid 1 rupee also, your ad will run. Okay, your ad will run even if you bid 10 rupees or 20 rupees also. Okay, as there are numerous websites and all, there is no competition. Your ad will get displayed somewhere the other. Okay, in some place or other place. So no worries about bid amount and all. But keep it in mind. Run your ads once and get an idea. So ad rotation, you know about this thing, which ad you want to show, like better performing ad, or definitely, okay, rotate your ads indefinitely, like such. So in what timing, on in which day you want to run your ads, start and end dates, you can also show this. And also which devices, okay, if we have any device preferences, like I want to show my ad only in computers, mobile phones, like that. Okay, and also choose specific targeting. You can also choose operating systems, like which operating system you want. So if you are running any ads for mobile app installs, and if it is an Android app, then it is no use. There is no use to show your ad for iOS people. People who are using iPhones, like such, there is no necessity of showing our ad to them. So based on your theme and all, choose the thing. Okay, device models, to which device models you want to show. Yeah, you'll be given with various models and all. Okay, you can show based on your requirement and all, you can select these things. Okay, I'm okay with everything. Okay, I want to show in on all devices. Okay, it may be mobile, desktop, or tablet, whatever it may be. Okay, so right. So let's go for targeting and all. Please give the ad group name. So I'll choose it as the display at group 11. 11, right? So now here in case of display advertising, okay, we can narrow our targeting. We can target people whom we want only. We can target based on location. We can target based on demographics. Demographics means here their age, gender. We can target based on customer interest. We can target based on specific keywords, where we want to show our ad, in which YouTube channel, in which website we want to show our ad, okay? We can make our targeting very, very narrow, okay? So in case of a search network campaign, we can target based on location only, okay? So, but in case of display network campaign, we can target our audience, right? So let's go for them, right? So you can also search for thing what you want. So you can, I'll go for digital marketing, like such. So based on this keyword, you can choose. Okay, I want to show my ad for this keyword. Okay, you can choose topics like whatever thing you want and all. You can choose some ideas. Even you can also browse like this, okay? So detailed demographics, like if you want to target people who are only single or who are only parents, like that, okay, you can also target them. For example, you are running an advertisement for a school. Then you have to show that school ad to parents only. If they are kids, okay? If they're having small kids like 6 to 7 years of age, kids will not be able to take a decision, right? So you have to show your ad to parents. So in that kind of cases, you can choose these things. And also you can choose their marital status. If it is like wedding photography and all. In case of education also, you can choose things, whatever you want, like whether he should be a graduate, like that. So as it is a digital marketing course, I want people to have a degree. So I'll choose this bachelor's degree. Okay. So, and also home ownership status, whether they are owners of the house or not, like such, you can choose. Okay. How Google will know all these things? Okay. How Google will know? So people might be searching for different things on Google. Google will be recording all these things. So only parents will be searching for kids wear. Kids footwear, like such, okay? Google will be recording all these things. Based on Google's analysis, Google will be showing up ads. They might be having Gmail accounts, they might be giving their details to Google, right? So based on that, Google will be showing ads. So right, if you are doing some real estate kind of business and if you want to show some flats, like such, to people, so it is better to show for renters and all, okay? We can also target people based on various other factors also. I'm okay with them till now. Let's go for this thing. So based on demographics means based on their age group and based on their gender, whatever it may be, you can also target people. We can also target people based on their household income. So again, I'll take the example of real estate. So if you want to sell a home for them, okay, the people should be able to buy them, right? So if their income is between some 1 lakh to 2 lakhs, then they can buy a home. They are ready to buy a home. If their income is between 10,000 to some 20,000 like that, they will not be able to buy a home. So keeping in mind all these things, please run your ads. So as it is my digital marketing thing, so anyone can join my course. So I'm okay with all these genders, age. So 25 to 34 age, it's enough for me. Obviously 55 to 64 age people will not learn. Okay. So like this, I'll choose to advertise between the age groups of 18 to 24 and 25 to 34. So parental status, it's okay for me, whatever it may be, not a parent or parent. It doesn't bother me. And household income. Okay. Their income can be anything. Okay. As it is not a big thing to learn a course, I'm okay with any income. But if it is in case of any real estate kinds of things and all, based on your business, choose the income level and all. Okay. So now let's go for content targeting. Okay. Here we can target based on three things: keywords, topics, and placements. Okay, so let's go for keywords. Right, so what is this keywords and all? Okay, let's see. So these keywords must be present in those particular websites. So our ads will be displayed in some websites or YouTube channels, or it may be on mobile apps like that, right? So whatever channels they may be, so these particular keywords should be present in those channels, then only our ad will appear there. Okay, if we show our ads on some relevant keywords like such, it is very good for us, right? So that's why it is better to choose proper keywords. Okay, in a simple sentence, the keywords I give here must be present in those websites. So in those websites only my ads will appear. Like I'll go for online digital marketing training, it scanned my websites and got some things, so I'll be showing my ads on my competitors websites also. It is also okay. Okay, what is digital marketing? So you can also give some other things like search engine optimization. So these kinds of keywords should be present there in those particular websites. So then only my ad will appear there. Okay, this is about keywords. You can choose what all ideas you want. Okay, so you should select this option. So here it says only shows ads on web pages, apps and videos related to these keywords only. Okay, we are showing our ad on related websites only. Okay, so done. Click on done. Next, I'll go for choosing topics. Okay, here again, topics means related topics. Okay, so the websites or web pages or videos that are having related topics chosen by us. Okay, then only our ad will appear there. Okay, your ad will show to all the topics that match your other targeting. Right, so to which topic my thing is related to? So internet and telecom. You can also have subtopics if you click here. So jobs and education. So my thing is somewhat related to education. So I want to show my ad on websites or YouTube channels or whatever it may be, which are related to these particular topics. Shopping, sports. Okay, also keep in mind, people might be interested in some other things also. Not only in education, people might be interested in some other things also. So choose the required topics and all. So books, literature, whatever it may be. So you can choose your related topics here. If it is related to automobiles and all, you can choose internships, jobs. So people who are interested in these things, okay, they will go to such kind of websites. So if they are interested in something, they will they might be also interested in learning something new, right? So I'll choose these things. Okay, if you don't want them, you can delete here or you can clear them. Done. Next, I'll go for placements. Okay, where I want to place my ad, I can choose. Okay, so in this specific website only I want to place my ad. In this specific YouTube channel only I want to show my ad. In this specific YouTube video only I want to show my ad. You can choose that. Okay, so wherever you want, you can show your ad. Only if they are running ads. Okay, so if that particular website is showing up ads, then only you can place your ad on their website. Otherwise you can't. Okay, simply you can search by URL. You can also search by names also. If you have any URL, simply you can click here and you can place here. Once you place here, if that particular website is running ads, then it will show you. So yes, it is in the website. So no results history, it seems. So YouTube channels. Okay, I'll choose my own channels like digital marketing. So in this related websites I want to show. So it will show me with the various websites. In whatever website you want, you can show. You can show in your competitors' websites also, like this you can show. Okay, like that you have to choose. you can display your ad on specific websites also. Like, see, this is online digital marketing training, ODMT YouTube channel. Okay, you can display your ad on ODMT also. Okay, like that, you can display your ads. And also app categories, like if you want to show your ad on some categories of apps, like cooking apps, or it may be some kind of e-learning apps, like that, you can choose. So there are various apps related to digital marketing. So you can choose any apps and all. So why I am choosing related things? Because as people are interested in those things, they might also be interested in my thing also. That's why I'm showing in related channels and related websites. That's it. You can also add multiple placements and all. So give any URLs or multiple placements. Like, let me choose this thing. So like this, in this particular website also your ad will be shown. Okay, so in this way we can show our ads which contain, okay, we can show our ads in websites or mobile apps, wherever it may be, which contain these particular keywords which are discussing about these particular topics. And we can also place our ad on specific websites or specific YouTube channels which we want. Okay, this is about targeting. So another thing I want to say is, okay, so we can show our ad only on publisher sites, which means the sites that are tied up with Google partner websites. We can show our ad on Google partner websites only. Okay, so these are known as the publishers. Okay, so Google partner website means they might be partnered with Google. They will give some space to Google in order to show ads. See, if you see this website, okay, actually this is my website, right? So, but here we people are seeing various ads which are not related to my website, right? Which means, so here the Crunch Stories is giving some space to Google in order to display ads. Okay, that's why this website is known as publisher website. Any doubts?
No.
So I'll say in here, if you see this picture, okay, actually here we are advertisers. Okay, we pay money to Google through Google Ads platform. Okay, pay money to Google through a Google Ads platform, and we say Google that we pay you, we will be paying you this much of amount, so please display our ads, like that will be saying to Google in the same way. So there will be some websites, okay, which are known as publishers. Okay, they will register with Google AdSense platform. These are all platforms of Google only, and they will give some space to Google in order to display others' ads in their website. As they are giving some space to Google in order to display others' ads, okay, Google will pay some money to them. Google will pay some amount of money to publishers. Okay, so now Crunch Stories will be getting some money as it is giving some space to Google in order to display others' ads. So in this way, we can earn some money. So in later classes, we'll be seeing in detail how to register with these ads and how to earn money and all. This is all known as Google Advertising Network. Even Google Ads is Google's platform, and Google AdSense is also Google's platform. But the thing here is, through Google Ads, we'll advertise or we'll promote about our business. That's why we are known as advertisers. Okay, through Google AdSense, will be earning some money by giving some space to Google in our website. So our website space will be given to Google so that it can display others' ads. These advertisers' ads are displayed on these publisher websites. That's why these people are known as publishers. So as these websites are partnered with Google in order to earn money, they are known as Google Display Partner websites. So in such kind of partnered websites only, we can show our ads. Okay, understood my point? In some websites you might not see any kind of ads. If you see ODMT, so you might not see any kind of ads in ODMT. Why? Because they are not interested in advertising, because their competitors' ads also might get displayed on ODMT. People may redirect to their competitors' websites also. So some people might not be partnered with Google and they will not be interested in showing ads. In such kind of websites, we can't show ads, guys, because they are not partnered with Google in order to show ads. Okay, in such kind of websites, we can't show ads. Okay, only websites that are partnered with Google, in those websites and those YouTube channels or those mobile apps only, we can show our ads. Clear? Right. So targeting expansion. So here it is asking to how many users you want to show your ad. Do you want a broad network or a narrower network like such? So I want to keep this like this only. Okay. If you want more reach, means if you want to show your ad to more and more number of people, you can go for more reach. So it will be shown to random number of people. You can think that you can choose more reach, but also the cost will differ, guys. So based on the, as the impressions will increase, the bid amount and cost will also will differ. Okay. So next thing is ad group bid. Okay. So enter your viable CPM bid. Means for 1,000 impressions, how much amount you want to pay. As I said, if you keep 1 rupee also, your ad will run. For 1,000 impressions, you will be paying 1 rupee. Why? Because there is no competition here. There are millions of websites, numerous YouTube channels, numerous videos, okay, numerous mobile apps, okay. SERP, there are limited positions, like only 7 positions. Within that 7 positions only you should display our ad. Like this, there are no limited positions. That's why we can even run our ads for 1 rupee or 2 rupees also. So I'll keep just 10 rupees for 1,000 impressions. If my ad displays for 1,000 times, I'll be paying Google 10 rupees. Right, done. So now I have to create my ad. Okay. So responsive display ad. So here, if you click on that, you can choose responsive display ad. Or if you create your own ads, you can upload those display ads also. Responsive display ad means, okay, this thing will automatically scan from your website and it will only take. And also it will only create various types of ads, like banner ad. It will only automatically create image ad. It will only automatically create various sizes of ads. See, this is of one size. This is of one size. Okay. So like that, Google only will automatically create different sizes of ads. Okay. So in case of responsive display ad, if you have created your own ads, okay, you can simply upload them from your desktop like such. Right, so I'll choose responsive display ad only. Here also you should give images. Okay, or you can simply scan from your Facebook page, you can simply scan from your Twitter page or Instagram page, or else you can scan from your website. See, it is showing me some images from my website. Okay, so if you don't want them, you can simply upload from your system also. I'll choose some image. Okay, so give proper images. So these images must be attractive. Then only people click on these images and come to your website. Okay, so make sure of that thing. In case of display network campaign, your ad should be attractive. I'll show you how to create and all. Okay, so I'll use this image. We have to give one logo and one image. Okay, so I will use this as image. Done. So select 2:1, save. And also image and logo, it has only chosen one. You can also add one different thing and you can choose it as a logo. I'll choose this thing. So I'll use this thing as a logo. So 1:1 selected, select 2:1, save. Done. Okay, so this is how it will display. Okay, in case of mobile, it will only automatically create different sizes of images. Okay, so you can see in case of websites and apps, okay, how it will display and all key ad formats. Okay, see image ads, text ads, like that, it will only create some ads. You can also see in case of laptop, see, it has only created a banner ad, image ad, various formats are there, in various dimensions, 480 by 120, 160 by 600. Okay, this is an advantage in case of responsive display ad. It will only create your ad in different formats. Done. Okay, now it is in case of a mobile, it will show like this and all. So let me give some headlines and all. Like digital marketing training, learn online. You can also give long headline and all. So description. It is showing me some suggestions from my website. Learn digital marketing. Okay, on the right hand side, it will be changing a bit. You can also write about offers and all. Okay, so like 50% off, like such. In case of display network campaign, we can also do remarketing. How we can do? I'll show you. What is remarketing means? Let's think that you people might have gone to Amazon. You might have searched for some product and then you place that product in the cart, but you haven't made a payment, which means you didn't buy the product. Then wherever you go, you might have gone to other websites, you might be browsing on Google or whatever it may be, you'll be followed by that specific Amazon product ad. Have you seen that thing? They'll be showing some discount, offer, sale or whatever it may be. In that way, you can also grab your customers back again. Business name, ad formats. So I'll choose auto-generated thing only. So in this way, you can give multiple ads. Okay, ad to ad group. Like search network campaign, you can create multiple ads. So, and also you can go and check for multiple things. Okay, which ad is working well like such. Headline, it is mandatory. So write these things properly because these things will be shown on here. See? So like this, you can create multiple ads, as many as you can. So after that, you can choose best performing ads so that which people are clicking most, or which ad is getting more interactions or clicks. That ad will be chosen as best performing ad. Click on create campaign. So that's it. Your display network campaign has been created. Okay, so that's it. You can also see, check here, go and check here which placements you have placed and all. You can check here. You can see which aged people you have targeted and all. You can check here. Okay, so like this, you can edit these things, remove these things and all. You can do. You can also see for what keywords your ads are getting displayed. Means that particular websites must be having these keywords. Okay, must be used in the content in those website, must have these keywords or these terms in there. Okay, so in this way, we can run display network campaign. So while creating a campaign, if you don't want to show your ad on a specific websites which contain sensitive content like such, you can come to content exclusions while creating a campaign and you can exclude them. You can simply tick on them and you can say, okay, opt out for showing our ads in these particular websites or the websites or YouTube channels that are having these types of sexual content or sensitive content or violent content or like such, in such kind of websites also you can reject them. Okay, you can, there is no need to show your ad there. And also you might, in case of interviews like such, you might be asked for a thing called frequency capping. No, I am not seeing here. Google might have removed it or whatever it may be, but I'll say. So what is this frequency capping? So in case of frequency capping, we can limit how many times you want to show your ads to the same user, right? So simply we'll restrict our ads. We can define how many times a ad should be shown to same user, right? So here there is no need to show your ad 10 times for the same user, right? We can save some impressions if you show them to different people. So in this way, we can also limit how many times our ad should be shown to a particular user. Okay, than showing 10 times to the same user, we can show 2 times to the one user and remaining times to some other users like that. Okay, this is known as frequency capping. Here we can limit how many times our ad should be shown to a particular user. So if you want to target that kind of person for multiple times, if you are having too much of amount and all, you can go for it. You can show as many times as you can to a particular user, and that's again your wish. Okay. In this way, you can do content targeting based on the age, demographics. There are various factors which we can target. You can also see some thing like delivery method. You might come across it. Google might have removed it. I have not been seeing that thing. So delivery method like such, someone asks, you might know about it. Okay, what is this delivery methods and all? There are two kinds of method. One is standard method and the other thing is accelerated method. Okay. So what are these terms? Standard means, so spending budget evenly over time. So if you want our ad to get displayed throughout the day, if you want to spread our budget evenly throughout the day, then we have to go for this standard delivery method. If we choose this method, our budget will be spent evenly over time and our ad will be shown throughout the day. If you go for accelerated kind of thing, okay, then we'll be spending our budget more quickly. Okay, then this may result in running off our budget very early. Okay, our ad will be shown multiple times. Okay, very quickly and very fastly our ad will be shown multiple times in case of accelerated method. So we have to choose this thing if we have immediate openings or if there is any offers the next day itself. And then if you want to reach more number of people, if you want to say people more about it, then you can go for this accelerated method. Otherwise, generally we'll go for standard methods only. Then we'll be spending evenly and our ad will be shown all over the day. If you go for accelerated kind of methods, our budget will be exhausted very quickly and also our ad will be shown numerous times within little span of time itself. Our ad will be shown multiple and multiple times. That's the difference between standard and accelerated delivery. Okay, so this is about the display network campaign.